Okay, we're standing here at Carolina Beach down in North Carolina, and we're going to talk a little bit about sedimentary environments just by looking at a couple of different places around the beach. The first thing that we're going to look at, we're standing in the swash zone, and we're actually at a low tide period. So if we look straight down at our feet, we can actually see some undulations in the sand down below the water. So if these were to get lithified and buried, they would actually become ripple marks that we could see. So if we find a sedimentary rock with ripple marks, one place we might look to think of the environment is at the beach. Another place that we can go and start looking and thinking about sedimentary rock environments is just by moving up the beach a little ways. So if we just take in and we step up a little higher on the swash zone and we look down, we start to see a lot of shells. Now, if we look really closely at all of these shells, they're all broken up, beaten up, so these have been worn down by the waves crashing on the beach. So if we find a sedimentary rock with a lot of broken shells, and they're all kind of combined together with some sand, then we can start thinking about this type of swash environment, okay? So it's a place where the water is running back and forth on the beach, and we're getting both sand and shells that are eventually going to become pieces of sand, okay? Now we can keep walking up a little bit higher on the beach, and one thing we'll notice is that there are footprints down below our feet. So these are modern day tracks made by humans. Other creatures that we might see would include things like sea stars, snails, worms. Worms are a big burrower, so we can start to see their little track marks sometimes in our sedimentary rocks as well. The last thing that I'm going to point out on our beach right here, if we take a step higher, we start to see that there's a place on the beach where we have mostly sand and a few little shells. If we look higher up the beach, there's some packets where we see large amounts of shells and they're collecting. Again, these are places where we might start seeing a coquina forming. We'll actually take a quick look up there in a minute. And then farther up the beach, we see mostly sand. So this is one location where we have all of these different types of zones and environments. So we could be seeing a lot of different types of sedimentary rocks forming in one small area. The last thing I'm going to point out before we end this video is if we look down here again, we're seeing a lot of shells. If we were to start to bury this, we might actually start to see the formation of a coquina, which is just a lot of loosely cemented shells. And it's very porous, so it's kind of a yellow color. It's a younger rock. It's not going to have as much sand inside of it. So then we could see at this beach, just remember, some sandstones with shells, some that's mostly sandstone, and then possibly a coquina that's made of loosely broken shells. And so that's one quick little look at some sedimentary environments on a beach. These would be modern sedimentary environments for today.